Hello, everybody. It's Dr. Zaino for 15 Minute Fuel. We're just in 15 minutes a day. We're going to fuel your mind, your body, and your future. Well, thank you guys so much again for another episode of 15 Minute Fuel. Once again, we're just going to do the announcements. As always, get on all of our social media. We're also on SoundCloud, Stitcher, iTunes for the podcasting type. People like to listen to it. We had an email today that someone loved listening to the podcast when they were working out, and they discussed it on the way home. How cool is that? We Are Heroes episode 31 came out yesterday. Make sure you check that out. Make sure you love it. We also had a really good teaser about the checklist in society. Maybe I'll talk about that today. Well, I'll talk about two things today. And also, you know, make sure you go to Dr. Zaino fan page. Go to YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat. Make sure you subscribe and follow and spread the word, all right? So when you hear this, you know, hit the share. And if you, you know, just give me your comments, you could private message the comments for any topics and any questions you want me to address during the 15-minute fuels. All right, so well, good. So good to see you guys. If you're on there, just please just say hi. If you are watching this live, just Pete's on, Pete Strombach, Jen's on. Dr. Jen, we had a great podcast this morning. She's going to kill it. Wait till you hear her podcast. And just say hello, because that's part of the community and it's part of us growing together. We're really making a huge movement, and we are really changing people's lives in a way far beyond that we did in just our practices. So today, I'll probably try to merge the two, but I had a call with a doc who was kind of struggling a little bit. He felt a little burnt out. And, you know, when that doc had a burnout question, I really got to hear them. So I set up a 15-minute call with them just to see where they're at. And I realized it's not that they were burnt out. Their life was totally being controlled by everything and everyone around them. And I realized they had no control for themselves. And I watched a podcast with Rob Bell in it, a recent one. And he said, one of the most essential things you could ever do is to take care of yourself in order to help serve others. So take care of yourself, whether it be your health, your mindset, your spirituality. You need to take care of you. It's what I call selfish and selfish, right? You need to take care of you to be able to go out and serve and help people in every aspect. And so I really realized in this talk, he wasn't burnt out. He was just drained. He was pulled apart. He found himself, because what happens when you don't take care of yourself, mentally, physically, socially, spiritually, and the things that you need, you start giving fragments of yourself to everybody around you, right? They need this, they need that, they need this and that. And then you find yourself an empty shell and you wonder why you're an empty shell, right? So then I realized, so the calendar was owning him. People were owning them. The job was owning them. Everybody else was dictating what they should and should not do and running around by a leash like a choke collar. And then it comes to this someday, I'm going to get around to it someday when I do my last chore. But in reality, if you keep on giving or being taken advantage of and doing what everybody else wants you to do, someday becomes the eighth day of the week. It never comes around. So this is where I said, listen, you're not burnt out. You're an empty vessel, right? You gave everything. You're an empty vessel. So now we need to take care of yourself. And so this is a very practical thing we'll do today. It's called owning your calendar. And when I do masterminds with doctors and anybody else, I'm talking about the calendar. And it's a very, very fun thing to do. You'll totally enjoy it. You'll love it. And it sets things up with your core values first. So what you do is you get your Google Calendar, you get your Apple Calendar. And if you're married, this is even better. So what you'll do, I'll just tell you from our standpoint, and you just, you know, make it yours. What you will sit down and we'll get on the Google Calendar and it's all blank, you know, for a full year. And the first thing we do is we dream, we have fun, and we put when of our family vacations are going to be. You know, so what are we doing for Christmas? That's fun, right? Oh, we're going to go to, you know, we're going to go to Park City. Great. You know, what are we going to do for Thanksgiving? Let's go to Park City again. So we put the stuff in there that we're going to do. Our vacations as a family. So we have longer vacations that are one week. Then we have maybe longer ones, 2 to 3 week kind of sabbaticals. Then we have vacations we put in there, long weekends, 2-3 days, or what, even one day out, that's just Whitney and I. So you put through the schedule your little short outings, and then your longer vacations. And then you should know when you feel the plane start to wobble, all right? You know what I mean? Like you're working and around week 5 or 6, you start to feel this, the plane starts to do this. Well, then you know if that's week 4 to 6 or 5 or 5 weeks, then you want to make sure at 4 weeks or 5 weeks you plan a long weekend. And that could be easy, and you don't even have to leave town. We have several friends and colleagues that, you know, we're in Houston here, and they may go downtown Houston for one night, right? And that's their little getaway. So it could be something small and very amazing like that. And so you don't have to go on this huge trip or fly anywhere. You could just do that little short trip just to kind of have a change of pace and a recharge and refresh. So you put in the calendar your family vacations, you put in the calendar your short weekend getaways or one night getaways with your spouse or with the kids. You just choose which ones are kids or not. You decide, what are you doing for Christmas? What are you doing for New Year's? So it's all planned. What are you doing for your birthday? Hey, you want to go here? Great, let's do that. So that's a lot of fun. So you put that in the calendar. That means nothing touches that. Now two, then what you want to put in there is, if it's a spouse, like a date night. You know, you put that date night whenever that is. So that could be a regular date night, you know, with your spouse. And then you could even put, you know, I have the daddy date night. So daddy date night seems to be Monday night for me. So Monday night after the dinners, the boys, you know, I take the boys out and we have a little daddy date night. And sometimes, mommy got dragged into that last night. And it was fun. And so that's why you do this. So you put your date nights in. And you put, if you have kids, put your kid date night in. Boom, it's solid. And I'll tell you why in a moment. So you put those. So it's in the schedule. It's not going anywhere. You plan for it. It's there. That's your time. It now is officially off the table. And now, so you got your vacations, all these other things, the kids' time in there, your date nights. Then if you want, you could put your personal time. So your personal time could be blocked off. So if you work out in the middle of the day, make sure between 11 and 12 is blocked off. It's done. That's your time. So, because I know for me, I need to work out. If I don't work out, I go crazy. Like I'm about to do a seminar for 3 days and I get so exhausted sitting down. If you've ever been sitting down for a while, so I'll make sure that during lunch, I'm at it. I'll have my workout time. So you have your workout time, that's blocked off. And then maybe your morning ritual time. So mine is pretty routine, so I don't put it in the calendar, but I kind of know between 4:30 and 6:30 is, but put it in there. I want you to get used to seeing the calendar that you're validating yourself by seeing that you took time for yourself. And what people don't realize, I spend as much time working on me outside of work than I do inside of work. So I would say 50-50. So if I work so many hours a week, I literally spend that many hours working on myself. Whether it be, the body, the mind, the spirit, the reading, the preparation. So I try to keep it 50-50 because if I don't work on myself the equal hours I work, then you're not going to get 100% of me at work. It just doesn't work out that way. So I'm constantly refueling, but I make it in the schedule. So you put those times in there. So you're putting you in first. Now put work in there. So for me, I know when I'm adjusting. I know every Monday night I do a dinner talk, so I put that in there every Monday night. I know one time a month I do an advanced talk, I put that in there, and it's in there every night. You know, I know my work schedule the rest of the week, so that's all in there. And I'll tell you what to do here. So the reason why I do the work now is because if I have to speak or anything like that, my team has access to my calendar. They know Friday night or Monday night, it's daddy date night. There's no, they don't ask me to do anything. They know between 11:30 and 12:30, I'm booked. I'm taking care of myself. Don't ask me to do anything. So they know. So I let my entire team know my schedule because they know, well, this is the time that's off limits. Because what happens is if I start giving up the workout time or personal time, if I start giving up the date nights and the daddy date nights, if Woody and I start giving up the vacations and the little dates here and there, then what starts to happen, things start to go like this. And we don't realize it. It's like a disease, right? It's subtle. You miss one, no big deal. You miss 10, now you miss 20. 2 years later, you wonder why this happens, all right? So this is why you want to make sure that everybody who is working with you knows these are off limits. So this is how you own your calendar. And I love the way to do that because then you do that for the year and then you have something to look forward to. So I know, like for me, I put seminars in there. So whatever seminars, and for you, what that could translate to is whatever your skill is, right? I want you to then develop the skill. And there's a seminar in every skill. So if you're, remember, your vehicle of influence to the world is either going to be speaking, video, writing, or audio, right? One of those four. And there's subtitles of that. So if you are a speaker and you're like, listen, I have a message and I want to get this out to the world, then start going to seminars to become a better speaker. Put those in and make, I would combine the little seminar with a little one or two day vacation, right? So put the speaking in. If you're a writer, go to a writing seminar, an author, learn more about that. So start planning your seminars because that's still personal development in your skill. Because as you develop the skill, now you can start doing and taking your message and what you love to do. So whatever that is. So for me, it's speaking, so I'll go, That's where I'm going this weekend, on how do you rock stages and get on really big stages. So I'm taking 3 days, and yes, I know, you know, it's 3 days, or actually 4 days, because that's a skill that I want to develop, and then I want to be able to use my skill and my talent the best way possible by learning from people who do that. So I totally encourage you, and this is how you get out of point A so you get to point B, C, and D, and continue on the journey. So you're right, so in review, look, you put in your vacations, your date nights, your short days out, your kid, the dates with the parents, not your kids, and maybe your parents, you know, and then you put your exercise time, or your personal development time, your workout, your personal time, your power hours, and then you put in your seminars that you'll go to, personal development-wise, what seminars you need to go to, put that in there. And then also now you have your work stuff. So now there's going to be empty hours. You'll see on the schedule, there shouldn't be many. But in those empty hours, you get to choose. Are you going to chill, which is nice. It's good to chill out sometimes. In those empty hours is more opportunity. So if I do speak, or if I can work a little bit more, I'll fill in those hours with that. So they become areas that are now open. So if I have a chance to speak, or I have to do another talk, boom, it'll be in those hours that are free. But my work and everything, my team knows where it needs to be. So so what I'm saying is, instead of saying I'll get around to it, put it in first. Put it in the calendar for a solid year. Get excited to look forward to it. You have something to look forward to. So hope is great. Let me tell you, when someone has hope, you know, that keeps them moving forward. Because, you know, it's nice to know that, hey, in 5 weeks we're taking a little trip. Or in 3 weeks we're taking a little trip. Or we're going to Vegas to see Justice's karate tournament in July. So you have these really cool things you're looking forward to, and it makes life a lot more exciting versus, hey, I'll get around to it, or I'll see, let me check my schedule. No way. You put life in your schedule. Remember, we have two top things. You have high-value income priorities, such as your work, and then you have lifetime legacy priorities. And those things, if we're able to put them in your life, because life is not just about, you know, running through time. It's about experiences backed up against experiences. And your goal is to get as many experiences backed up to one another as possible in the time we have in life. And that's what makes life amazing, because the stories are in them, the opportunities are in them, the unknowns are in them. So make sure you do that. So I appreciate you guys for everything. And let me see, what was the other thing? Was the checklist. Okay, so I'll talk about the checklist maybe tomorrow. So the checklist, if you go and look at my teaser on Instagram or Facebook, you'll see that I talked about, like, you know, for the first 30 years, society has given us a checklist. And then we think, hey, if I just check this checklist off, I'm going to be happy. So that's kind of a preview of what we'll talk about tomorrow. And I think you know where I'm going with that. So that's what you do. It's very easy. Have fun tonight. I want you to sit down with yourself or your spouse, if that applies, or a significant other. Look at a full year on Google. I like Google. And have fun. What are you doing for Christmas? What are you going to do for New Year's? And get excited. What are you going to do for your birthday? You want to go to South Beach? Let's go to South Beach. So you plan these things in there. When are you going to work out during the day? You know, what are the things you're going to do? And you put all the things you want to do that's building your life and experiences, and then put work in there. Have work and all that stuff come after that. And so you know that you have the time to do the things that will make you better, the seminars and personal development, and you know you still have that area that you're going to make a living in. So doing the calendar this way, yes, you're going to work to make a living, but you're actually planning to build a life. And that's what it's about. So have an amazing day with 15 Minute Fuel. I will be on location tomorrow, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. So give me a little bit of grace when we get on, but I will definitely be live and kind of give you an update of what's going on at the speaking event I'll be at. Have a blessed day. Make sure you share. Because how many people would love to do this? It's very practical. They could do it, and it's a lot of fun. Hit the share button. Share that. Thumbs up. Big hearts. Have an amazing day. And we'll see you tomorrow with 15 Minute Fuel, which is in 15 minutes a day. We'll fuel your mind, your body, and your future. God bless.